I welcome the Electoral Commission for 1963 claiming of intentional wrongdoing. My honesty and my integrity have been confirmed by this judgment. I accept entirely the Electoral Commission's decision, as I have expected all along, a mistake was made. Significant steps were taken to ensure compliance. It is, however, clear that our system of checks did fail, which I entirely accept. Lessons have and will be learnt. I also welcome the Commission's decision that there is no basis for any finding of intentional wrongdoing on the part of me or my campaign team. As I have been claimed from the outset, there was no intentional wrongdoing on my part, and I have now been vindicated by the independent body charged with policing electoral law. I deeply regret that my campaign accepted a £950 donation, which it transpired was in breach of the rules, and I apologise again to colleagues, to my party, and to the public. It was and is my intention to comply with the spirit and letter of the rules, and I cooperated fully with the Electoral Commission's inquiry from the outset. I also very much welcome the fact that due process has been observed following a thorough investigation by the responsible independent regulator. And I hope other political parties who supported both the legislation and the regulatory role of the Electoral Commission will now accept its conclusions in this case. Personally, this has been a salutary and a bruising experience. Some of the coverage has hurt me and caused distress to many entirely innocent friends, to my family and to donors. But I said at the outset, I would not walk away from the leadership of Labour in the Scottish Parliament. And let me now add to that pledge. I will not walk away from my party or from the people of Scotland, while there remains a job to be done in restoring social justice to the top of the political agenda, fighting poverty and making Scotland a fairer and more prosperous place for everyone to live in. I came into public life to serve, and I intend to continue to serve people of Scotland as the leader of Labour.